in advance for the music tonight. I hope I don't keep you up too long.
Look, hey, what makes you think you're going to be keeping her up? She might be keeping you up.
Yeah, Jones, my neighbour.
All right, nice to meet you, Jones.
Jones lived in that house for how long?
63 years.
Long time. Yeah, but it's nice to see this place full up with people.
That's your job. I'll race him. If he agrees, I'll race him.
Tell him the gauntlet has been thrown down. It's up to your dad to pick it up.
He might beat me these days. I'm not very good anymore.
Just say to him.
Where's baby?
Steve's having an accident. All right, Graham. Yeah, very good at a wedding, lady.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Is that what it is?
Look, say hello to Ray. Pull your skirt down. Make yourself decent.
Hello.
Yeah, of course.
Yeah, when
were you?
I came to the house.
Sorry,
I don't want one of those.
Well, you don't want one of these.
Yeah, with the boys. Mr. Hurst. It's Luke. That's definitely got to be paid for the visit later.
Yeah, I was just thinking that.
Absolutely.
Shuffle the kids off a bit.
Hey, yeah. So you go on it.
Absolutely.
A bit of you right there.
Definitely. Yeah. As soon as the kids are out of the way.
I think they can sleep, do you?
They will. They'll wear themselves out, won't they?
That's what you think.
Well, yeah, you hope so.
Oh, I can't do it. I can't do it.
Excuse me.
Go in the swimming pool?
Yeah. No, sorry, the bounce castle's gone. Go on.
Children,
I'm a father of hell,
stand.
I'll be filming your speech.
I'll be in a minute. I'll be back in again in a while.
Get used to it.
I'll get
Gamma
and
Alice. Wow. That woke everyone up. Huge head right in the way. Yeah, you see that.
The mic's coming to me. Elvis Stardust.
There's the man himself. Do you know what? Everyone does it.
I know. You see, it's a thing about having camera
reports. It's a natural reaction. You can't behave normal, can you?
Do you know what our friends done at one of their weddings, which I thought was a fantastic
idea? They sat reading the news.
They sat in like an aisle, spoke to a video camera. As people was passing by, you see the corridor, and he said, so how do you know it was Julia Eric's wedding? So how do you know Julia Eric? And you had to sit down and explain sort of how you sort of knew and say something.
Shame. Okay. Right. Well, I'll just wander off around the back of here so you can't see what I'm saying.
Come and sit down.
No, okay, seriously. Thank you all for coming today. It's fantastic to see so many friends and family together in one place. And I hope you've all got a glass of champagne ready for some toasts that are coming up. If you haven't got one, shout now. No, good. Okay, well, as I said, it's good to see everybody together. For me, particularly, to see my family here today on a happy day, because it's usually over recent years been funerals. So to see you all smiling for a change instead of crying is a welcome change. But as I said, food's going to be coming up in about 20 minutes, so I've just got a few words to say and then I'll hand over to Barry, my best man, who apparently is going to embarrass me terribly. And once he's ruined me, he'll hand over to Nikki's dad, Rennie, and again he'll say a few words. So, thanks for coming. I hope you're enjoying the day so far, and I hope you all stay late into the night and have a dance and have a good drink with us all. As you see, it's a very informal occasion, and just do whatever you want to do. If you want to swim, if you want to jump on the bouncy castle, then go jump on it. But above all else, please just have a good day today. Next, I want to thank Nikki for being my wife today. We've known each other for a few years now, and it's taken a while, but yeah, we finally made it. She is the best thing that's happened to me, and I love her to bits. And Nikki, stand up a sec. Doesn't she just look beautiful, everybody? Yeah, she does. Well, she certainly made me the happiest man that's here today. And yeah, I hope that we've got a lifetime of enjoyment together, I'm sure. Okay, I'm going to duck out now. I'm going to give the mic to Barry and let him, as I say, ruin me. Don't believe a word he says, because it's all lies, every single bit of it. But yeah, here's Barry.
Right. Just a moment. Well, I was just going to say good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and just like to start by thanking everyone for coming and making Lee and Nikki's special day a very special day. And aren't they beautiful and happy couple? I'm sure we wish them all well. So my name's Barry, and Lee in his madness has asked me to be the best man.
Speak up.
And I really do believe him when he says that all the other blokes that he asked to do it today just couldn't, they did have real commitments and they couldn't make it. Because he only asked me yesterday. And so I'm standing here unprepared, nervous, but I'm really ready to dish the dirt on Lee in revenge for putting me through this this ordeal. So here we go. So me and Lee have been mates for more than 30 years. And we met at infant school and have been friends ever since. Or at least he likes hanging around with us anyway. But all of us met at the same time, and so I've been asking them all to come up with all the juicy gossip and the embarrassing things that Lee's been involved with over the years. And we got loads, man. Got a separate list. So yeah, we got loads and loads of stuff, and where is it? And so now, as English tradition dictates, in case the South Africans here didn't realise this, but it's tradition to assassinate the groom's character at his wedding speech. You squirming, Lee? You ready?
Yeah.
Well, anyway, that was the plan. Anyway. But between us all, we come up with nothing. We could. There's nothing. There's no dirt at all on Lee Whitey, and there really isn't. There's no embarrassing things. He's never got himself into a scrape that he couldn't get himself out of, except for that grubby episode with the nuns in Amsterdam. But I promise that I won't talk about that. So you're all right, Ed. But seriously, though, there isn't any scandal at all with Lee. He's always been that bit smarter than us, and that bit sharper than us, and always that one step ahead. So while we was being sick in the toilets and getting beaten up by the bouncers, Lee would be outside sorting the taxis, pacifying the police, and getting all the girls safely away in his car. But smoothing things over and getting us home, we were the stupid drunken ones, and Lee was always the smart one, the wise one, the rock. Steve gave me that one, he's always the rock. So sorry folks, there's no dirt on Lee at all, he's just not like that. But it's for these reasons that I'm standing in playing the best man to one of the wisest, one of the sharpest, the kindest, biggest eared, portly and most honourable friends that a boy could ever have. So Lee Whaley, you are the best man, mate, old pal, and you've got one of the smartest, wisest, loveliest and prettiest girls here to prove it. Well done, mate. See, I told you he was sharp. So congratulations to the both of you, and ladies and gentlemen, the toast is the bride and groom.
Bride and groom.
Bride and groom.
Well done, pal. Guy, take that microphone from me.
Barry, I'm glad you didn't tell me all the things you told me you was going to say that you didn't, because you certainly saved me some embarrassment. But I'll hand you over now. For those of you who don't know him, this gentleman standing next to me is Rennie. It's Nicky's dad, and I think he's got War and Peace in his top pocket that he's going to read to you now.
Thank you, Lee. I'm not like these youngsters. I have to write things down. Now, I don't want this to sound like a start of a very long sermon, but here we go, here goes. We're all gathered here today to celebrate Nikki's big day, her wedding day. The Nikki that we all love, and none more than myself and her mother, Florence, down at the bottom there. The same lovable person that by her presence alone can brighten up a room. And yes, the same girl that can talk the leg of a hind leg of a donkey. I don't know if any of you have ever wondered how it sort of became a characteristic of her to talk so much. Well, I'll have to admit to some of the blame. And today is the opportune time to share this with you. I'd actually started. It was a few days after she was born, and I fetched Florence, her mother, her from the nursery. And on our way home, we stopped at some shopping centre in the neighbourhood. corners needed to buy a few things. And we parked in the center, either the first or the second, perhaps the fourth level, I can't remember. And Nick was left in my care. We had a long conversation. Mona Locke, I might add, at that stage she was still in training. I was so proud of my firstborn and told her many things. This one-sided conversation became long, very long. And in fact, Florence could not remember where she left us. Was it the first, second, perhaps the fourth level? Panic, panic. And I think two important things happened that day. Number one, Nikki got her first taste of talking for hours on end. And a pastime she still enjoys today. In fact, I think her second best friend is a telephone, any telephone, as long as there's somebody else on the other side. The second thing is that her mother eventually found us, and that I'm very grateful for. I could not see myself shaping up with a breastfeeding routine. The other characteristic of Nikki that we had to steer in the correct direction is her imagination. We were compelled to send her to university in order for her to obtain the facts, and all the facts. This is because if Nick only got some of the story, she would manufacture the rest her own way. And this became abundantly clear while she was still at pre-primary school, and we were almost thrown out of town for my wicked drug and drinking habits. The real and factual story begins on a particular Saturday morning when I decided to mow the lawn. There was no fuel for the lawnmower, and I did not have the time to go to the garage to buy some. So I decided to siphon some petrol from my car. Now this procedure, as those of you who attempted it before will know, requires a small diameter pipe fed through the fill of the car, and then you suck at the other end to fill the tube, load it and fill the container. However, in my haste, I did not slow the sucking in time, and so I ended up with petrol in my mouth, foul tasting stuff. Nikki, who was never seen this operation before, was standing somewhere, I didn't even know that she was there, observing. And when this fearsome spitting and possibly very colored language from me started, she vanished. She vanished. And nothing more was said, or anything was mentioned. I had no opportunity to explain what the aim of the operation was. However, the next week at school, Nikki very proudly announced, "My daddy drinks petrol." Nick has another characteristic, which I'm sure she inherited from her mother, that is to take control of a situation when the going gets tough. However, when she was younger, she sometimes read the situation wrong and took control before it was called for. Just such an occasion was during one of our much enjoyed summer holidays we had as a family in Nazeing on the garden route in South Africa, for those of you who don't know, and I'd acquired a speedboat, which we enjoyed on the lake, but at that stage I did not know the channels that well. And any of you that knows, it's a sort of a estuary, and it's very subject to the tides. On this afternoon, Nick, Adrian and I myself decided to visit the other side of the lake. We left at high tide and started our return journey when the tide was receding. We often got stuck on the sandbanks and had to get out to push the boats. And much to the annoyance of her brother Adrian, Nikki decided to, rather than help with the pushing, she would stand at the wheel and direct us. How she figured the route with herself really knowing where to go can only describe to woman's intuition and training. We arrived at the camp very late that evening. And yes, some might have guessed, besides being the captain of the boat, she was also a radio Nazeing. And along with the directions, also commented on everything she laid her eyes on. Remember that? And it was a long time to get back. Now, today, she again decided to stand up in her own ship, directing the way. A very long way from her birthplace, a very much matured young woman who decided to tackle the responsibility of marriage and raising a family, assisted by the knowledge and hopefully the wisdom that we as parents try to impart on her. Nikki's new family will be 3 girls and 2 boys. Lauren, Kirsty and Serena, as well as Oscar and Lee. Now a bit of information for you, Lee. Not advice. You might own the ship, but you are not a captain. This is a statement of fact. You will be responsible for the smooth running of the engine room, the tightening of the nuts of discipline and the bolts of fairness. You will keep the deck clear of obstacles such as anger, pettiness and spite. And during a storm, you and Nick will go below to stow away your most precious cargo of love and mutual respect in a safe and secure place. Then, some advice for all the fellows here. And this is Eve's advice. Those who are married, as well as those who are contemplating to do so in the future, the sooner you accept that you are needed in the engine room and leave the captain to do her things, the smoother your journey of life. Accept this from an old sea dog with 34 years of experience on the good ship marriage. Now, I ask you please to stand and raise a glass to my lovely daughter, Nikki, and well done, Nick.
Yeah. To Nick F.
I've been told that there's a tradition, well, there's a couple of traditions in South Africa that I have to try out on you lot, apparently. And one is the English tradition of the throwing of the bouquet to all of the unattached females. But there's then the throwing of the garter to all of the eligible bachelors. So first of all of you unattached females need to come to this end onto the lawn.
There you go, mate.
And be ready to catch.
Give me that, then I'll go and film you.
Come on. Up you come, Nick.
I'm a cameraman.
Yeah, that's you.
Eligible bachelor.
Don't be fair to all the others, mate. I'll bet they are.
Steve, doesn't Jackie qualify for this one? Come on,
I'm barging out the way.
So as tradition goes, whoever catches this is the next one in line for marriage. And God help them, that's all I can say.
Oh, I don't know. Okay,
on three. One, two, three. Yay! Unlucky, Rob.
What's the Scottish connection?
Rob, you realise you really want that thing. You're in trouble, mate.
What South Africans are like?
Okay, so now it's the boys. Eligible bachelors, whoever you are. Steve, Mick, Barry, Wraith.
I'm filming.
Jonathan, come on, all of you.
Fine.
Who else isn't married?
It's all fair, really.
No, Uncle Ray just got a
one. Sweaty guy.
I'm busy.
Surely there's more than that. Come on.
Me.
No. Rafe. Come on. You've got to play. No, you've got to play. Give the camera to Eddie. that'll do. Okay. You're fine. Okay. My leg up.
And there goes Rose.
Right. I'm not sure either. Don't tremble too much. Okay. Ready, fellas? On three. One, two, three. I think that was Barry.
No, he didn't, did he?
Excellent, okay. Do we know if the food's ready yet? Anybody? Is the food ready? Okay, excellent. Okay, we've got a whole roast suckling pig up there that's going to be carved up. There's some salads and everything else, so please feel free to dig in. Thanks.
Yeah.
You should have said it.
Well done, Belle.
Spirits.
me from talking.
No, you can do that again, I missed it. Auntie Precious says, where's her cupcake gone? Don't speak to the mouthful, it's rude now.
You got better than mine.
So yeah, have some cake, please. Want a cake, have a cake.
Love before. For a love that I thought I couldn't find. I said, yeah. For the one that's mine, oh my. I played around with love before. I was silly, and you know that I played the fool. But then you came into my life and you changed that. Now I know what I want to hear it say. With you. Since I found you, I'm in love with you. I found love in. Since I found you, I'm in love with you. I found love in.
Go on, Craig. Sing it, boy.
So then flow. The picture that's so right, you're my delight. That's why I love you so.
It's picking up the sound, that's
for sure. I've been around with love before. I was silly, and you know that I played the fool. But then you came into my life and you changed that. Now I know what I want, where it's at. With you, I found love in. Since I found you, I'm in love with you. Since I found you, I'm in love with you. Get up there, you arsehole! I found love in. I found love in.
You what? Sounds like he's swallowing the microphone.
Yay!
Hey!
Woo! Go on, Graham!
J-Man! J-Unit!
I didn't say that. I didn't shout more.
J-Unit.
Yeah.
Marvellous.
Lovely!
Yeah. Super!
It's got funny, eh?